Hello, everybody. I have had this for ages, and when I say ages, I think I've had it for about 6 years. It's been so far down the list of review items. It was imported by JML into the UK because it's full of Americanisms, but what grieves me even more is not the incorrect spellings of the word colour and whatnot. It's the overuse of, if you know me long enough, you know what I'm going to say. Exclamation marks! Leave control and one alone. Within its top little hanger bit, there's already two exclamation marks. On the top, three. Is it three? Yeah. Right. I'm not going to keep banging on about it because you're going to see every time you see an exclamation mark, engage the rage meter of what I am feeling. It really bugs me. Anyway, it's so bright, and they've trademarked the misspelling of bright. Very original. I don't think it was worth trademarking. Was it worth the money? Was it? It says, as seen on TV, I have not seen this on TV. It says, seven soothing colours instead of colours. I think white is a bit of a cheat. And mean, if you're going to get anything that's LED, if you put all the LED colours on, it's going to make white light. It's a bit rude. Stupid. I've got the white. Oh, it's still got bits of dust on it. I thought I'd dusted off all the dust. Anywho, that's a good thing, isn't it? Yes. Look, everything. They've had to put an exclamation mark on everything. And the soap that I've got to put in it, I thought would be enough, but it is a little less than 12.8 flosses. I mean, 800 and, I mean, 380 mil. It holds, which is a random number. Why can't it just be 500 mil? But anyway, I got some lovely fresh lime hand wash from Boots. And shall we have a smell of it for YouTube? Because it's going to go into this thing anyway. Let's have a go. I'm going to have to get batteries for this, aren't I? Oh, flipping heck, I didn't check. Have a smell for YouTube. I bet that smells good. Does it smell good? Oh, yeah, that smells gorgeous. That smells exactly like the lime-flavoured Skittles. Or opal fruits back in the day before they changed to stupid Starburst. I love lime. It smells so fresh. I like it better than lemon. Oh, that smells gorgeous. Anyway, let's look at the back, shall we? It's got lots of unnecessarily grinny, happy people on the packaging. Well, two. And they're not even using it, look. I don't know where they're looking at. That picture is just stock picture for anything, isn't it? Great for bathrooms or kitchens, exclamation mark. Well, why not pour it in? You might have a separate toilet. There you are. Is it not good enough for there? Cool to touch, exclamation mark. Right, three AAA batteries, not included. I'm gonna have to get some batteries. Light automatically turns on when motion is detected. Light only turns on when dark. Light stays on for 30 seconds and turns off automatically. I've said that twice now. Battery operated. Twist off cap. Long lasting colour changing LED. And LED. You can tell when it's text to speak, can't you? Because it always says LED instead of LED. Motion detector detects movement up to 10 foot. What's 10 foot? I'm going to make an ad to ask Google. Okay, Google, what is 10 feet in metric?
10 feet is 3.048 meters.
So just over 3 meters. That's quite a good distance. Color select button. Oh, so you can select the color you want. Very, very good. Lighted soap dispenser. I think that's enough of the packaging now. Shall we tear into this? Soap dispenser. Nightlight! There's the seven colours. Blue, green, pink, red, white, violet, lime. Oh, well, if my soap is already lime coloured, can it be overlined? Is the white still going to be white? We don't know. You'd have to have white flavoured, white coloured hand wash, wouldn't you? And where do you get clear hand wash? It's so often coloured, isn't it? Twist off cap, yes. I think I've read everything on that now, and that's just where it was imported from. I can't remember where I bought this from. Could have been in Bridlington, actually. I could have got it from Yorkshire Trade, and they're quite notorious for importing random tut. It says it's just writhing to get into it. Is it going to have an instruction book as well? Is it going to say how to wash your hands? Look, they spelled sanitizer wrong with an exclamation mark. I think that bugs me even more than anything else. Right. Oh, my God. Oh, I thought there was a leaflet in there, but it's not. That's just the plastic top lid thing, which is unnecessary. I think that was going to stay in anyway. You saw how difficult it was for it to tear off. Oh, is that a dead spider in there? I know it had been in there a long time, but no, it's not a dead spider. It's dandelion seeds. If I'd have grown this a bit more, would have had dandelions growing out of this. And what's that in the bottom now? What's this? Oh, it's wobbly. What's that? Oh, it's like the rest, to rest it on. All right, so I see. Little bits of water get collected in that and it goes all mouldy and disgusting. That's a good idea, isn't it? Put an exclamation mark on that. And you fill it up, like, how? I can see this getting disgusting pretty quickly. It's good that that unscrews, sort of, I think. But the way it screws in, water's going to get down into that and it's going to get full of bits of toothpaste and spittle and muck and grime, isn't it? I mean, look at it already. It says, hilariously, on the bottom, for some reason, sturdy plastic construction. All right, then. I just like, what a random thing to write on. This is the pump, and oh, it has got a... It is hard to see in real life, but it's probably easier to see on camera because things often are. Stop is up and up, open is that way. All right, I better put it on and do that, hadn't I? It just actually feels nice and tacky. Right, I'm trying to turn it on. It's not doing anything. Can you imagine if it was broken after all this time? It's not doing anything. Is it Brock? I'm trying to turn it on and it works. It just keeps unscrewing. That's annoying. Maybe if I... Oh, there we go. Woo! Now it's popped up. Yes, good spring action there. Right. Without getting it... I should have washed this out, shouldn't I? Have a smell for your tube. Does it smell old and fusty? No. Oh, it smells... That's weird. You know what it actually smells of? You know when you've drunk an entire bottle of Coke? And then you just smell the carbon dioxide in the bottle afterwards. Ugh, that's what it smells like. Well, anyway, we already know it's not going to go all the way up. I'm going to have to find some batteries. If you hang on a minute. Oh, it's got a little gasket in there. For some reason. Oh, that's the LED. The very small LED. Where's Big Clive when you want him? He'd be able to tell me all sorts about this. That rubber gasket is awful. That's just not going to stay in, is it? That's going to get chewed up every time you unscrew it. Right, I need to see if I've got some batteries. Oh my God, I don't know, I managed to miss it. These instructions. I thought there would be. So JML have just shoved this leaflet in and they've actually gone and stuck in a sticker. Not neatly, you know, it's a bit wonky. They just shoved it in. Right. Congratulations on your purchase of Soap Bright. I don't like being congratulated by tacky pieces of plastic. Anyway, please read these instructions before using the Soap Bright lighted soap dispenser. For best results, follow the instructions exactly. Instructions for use. To install batteries, remove the silicon base and open the battery cover located on the bottom of the unit. Unscrap unit and fill with your favourite liquid soap, sanitizer or lotion. It bugs me that JML have also put a Z for sanitizer. Right. Unit is on and light will turn on automatically. Oh, then in bold and underlined. I'm surprised I'm not putting an exclamation mark on. Lights only when dark. So that means I've got to go out of the bathroom, turn the light off, and then shut the door, and then walk in with no lights on. Is this encouraging people to walk into the bathroom without putting the lights on? That's not a stupid thing to do at all, is it? Select your desired light colour. Oh, they spelled colour correctly. Look, there's a U in colour. By pressing the colour select button. Clean with a damp sponge or cloth. Do not submerge in water. Ooh. Hand pump pressed down to dispense soap. Well, duh. Unscrew cap to fill with liquid soap or sanitizer. Hint, use a coin to twist open close the base cap. Ooh, that's a hint. Patronising bar stewards. Motion sensor detects motion up to 10 feet, which we now know is just over 3 metres. Colour select button, press cycle through the colours. Silicon base, battery compartment. There we go. And it's only on one side. There we are, look. The silicon base is appalling. It barely fits. And it's just gonna store the water. I've just dropped it already. That's just gonna collect water and make that horrible slime that only happens in the bathroom. Blech. Let me get some batteries. Not only does this product encourage you to walk into the bathroom in the dark, but it's got no proper real good child safety catch on there, has it really? There we go, open. There we go. And usually it says, what's the other warning you always put on something about batteries? I can't think what it is. What is it you're supposed to not do with batteries? Does anyone know? Let me know in the comment section what you're supposed to not do with batteries. Well, it's definitely not dark in here and it's turned on already. Oh, green, pink. Well, it was violet, I suppose. Red, blue. It came on straight away, didn't it? Where's the white? I'm getting all the other colours. Is the blue really meant to be the white? Don't know. Let's get this filled up and put in the bathroom. I better put the bottom back on, hadn't I? Is that going to go on? Oh, it will do if I do it the right way, won't it? is this going to go back on? Oops. Yes, it will. There we go. God, that is so not watertight, because there's no plastic gasket bit in that bit, is there? Or rubber gasket. That is just pathetic. Let's fill it up. I hope I don't get green sludge on the settee. Sherlock would not be pleased. I could just use the... I wonder if you can use any lid. Let's see if that fits. Does that fit? It does. I think that's a standard thing. It is. I mean, don't go all the way at the bottom. But we've lent something. It's a standard-sized lid. I mean, I will squidge most of that off. There we go. Yeah, I'm doing it all over my fingers. Yeah, I got soap all over my fingers. What am I thinking? Right, and we'll just pour this in. We'll gloop that in. Oh, this smells so good, future YouTube. If you're not living in future YouTube, if you're living in this very primitive current day YouTube, which is 2023, feel free to sniff. Oh no! Oh no! I don't have any to waste. Okay, come on, get in. There we are. Give it all back in. There we go. Yeah, feel free to smell some llama-flavoured Skittles or, you know, the green ones. Or go back in time and smell something that smells sweet and llamy that's in the sweet variety. Chocolate llams I used to love. And there's like llama and cream sweets as well that Woolworths used to sell back in the day. But Woolworths is long bust now. And, right, I think that's obviously defeating the purpose, because now I've got an empty bottle with little bits in that... I mean, there's still enough in there to do a few hand washes, isn't there? Right. That's as much as I'm going to get in for the video. I'm just going to go wash my hands, because I've currently got hand wash all over my hands, and I don't want to keep it on too long. My hands smell good enough to eat now. So these separate dispensers I've never been a fan of anyway, because this always happens. They make a mess. They're either too big or too small for whatever hand wash you buy. And I've switched to hand soap because it's a hell of a lot cheaper to use bars of soap to wash your hands with. Bars of soap have been given a huge disservice, but they save a lot on packaging and plastic. I'm not overly worried about the use of plastic or anything. I just hate pointless things. I mean, now I've got this to sort of use up somehow, because there's leftover product in there, which is difficult to get out. And that's just going to be knocking around the flat now. And bars of soap are just more natural. And I know this boot stuff's all right because I've had other smells of it before. This is the first time I've bought this one. But I usually can sometimes get contact dermatitis from hand washes because of the mix of chemicals they've used. And, yes, with bars of soap, I've never had a problem with that itchy contact dermatitis between your fingers. Right, this looks awful. Let's get it in the bathroom in the dark and let's see if it works. Here we are in the bathroom. I've remembered not to put the light on so the extractor fan don't come on, because the extractor fan's, I think, broken and it's really loud at the moment. Now, on the camera, this looks as if it's got two colours and it's only green at the top and the bottom is like a pinky colour. I hope this is going to come across on YouTube as I'm seeing it in real life and not as I'm seeing it on this screen. It's a bit bizarre because I'm not too sure what colour that is meant to be, because obviously... Right, let's cycle through the colours. I don't know what colour that was meant to be. Because my hand wash is green, this has gone like a sort of brown colour. That's awful. And it's not very bright at all. The street light at the window is brighter. that's not good. What's the next colour? I'm presuming maybe that's green. It's hard to tell because of the hand wash colour. What's the next colour? That's really dark again. I think the brightest colours I'm going to get from this is maybe the white or the green, isn't it? That's really dim. It's barely reflecting off the tap next to it. The bar of soap's there. That's what's... If you can see that, I don't know. And I've got the toothpaste at the other side. Can you even see them? This bit of reflection, where's my thumb? My finger. That bit of reflection's the tap. As you can see, the soap is very close to the left and to the right is the tap, and then just next to the tap is the toothpaste, and I can't see them. This is a very dim thing. And all the batteries are new. So that's either the light white or the green light. As you can see, it's a little brighter. You can now sort of see the toothpaste. You can see the tap. And you can see the bar of soap pretty much on the left. What's the next colour? Oh, red. The red is reasonably one of the better colours. Yeah, you can still see the soap. See a bit of the tap. But this is not bright enough for you to go to a toilet in the middle of the night. I mean, it's still very dark in here. You do yourself an injury. What's the next colour? It just went like a dimmer red colour. And then we're back to this, which is either green or white. I think this is the brightest one. Yeah, because you can see the soap. You can see the... Can you see both tubes of toothpaste? You can definitely see the tap. And that's it. I'm not a fan of it. I don't really like it because I am going to turn the light on now. So mind your eyes, everybody. I'm about to turn the light on. If you're watching this in bed, maybe like screw your eyes up a bit. Or 3, 2, 1. I've given you plenty of warning now. Ugh, flipping extractor fan's so loud. yes, as you can see, not very bright at all. That's my review. Ugh, I suppose it's a soap dispenser. I should see if it actually dispenses. Right. What's the... It probably dispenses too much. Another reason why I don't like liquid soap is when you use it, you usually use... You give it on your hand and then instantly it runs off down the drain. Whereas with a bar of soap, you're picking it up. I did a whole YouTube on it, why soap saves money, plastic and money. Again. Come on.
Also seems to save time using soap as well. But I think it's Brock. Oh no, there it goes. That one good. That's not a good colour, is it? This is actually too much soap immediately. I can see it foaming up in the sink. Yes, it's designed probably by somebody who also has shares in liquid soap companies. Yeah. My hands just don't feel as clean with liquid soap. I prefer to use a bar. See, look. Instantly, look, it's about that. And because it's a bar of soap, the 20 seconds of washing has already started by mushing the soap into your hands. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. And just by washing my hands, that is already wet. And how long do we think that's going to last? Ooh, not long, is it? Scrubs, bye. Oh yeah, I should really count for when it turns off, shouldn't I?
Talking through the crack of the door, did it turn off or is it going to be like the fridge light?
It's going to be like the fridge light and you're not going to know if it's turned off or not. Did it turn off? I'm going to walk in as slow as possible. Oh, it did turn off! Oh, let's see if it turns on. Oh, it did turn on in the dark. It does work. So the sensor does work. There we are. So that's at least that one thing.